Just making sure you're not sitting in some poop, because outdoors.
We're at Dupuis Campground.
Dupuis, doesn't that sound fancy?
I do. I think it's super fancy. This is a free campground, part of the South Florida Water Management District and the Fish and Wildlife. And it's awesome. And we're going to have another edition of Keto Coffee Talk.
Coffee Talk.
And I have a question for you.
Yes.
Is this keto?
Absolutely. It's seltzer water.
Of course it's keto, right? Is milk keto?
No.
Why not?
Because it's milk. Hey, what's up, family? I'm Rachel.
And I'm Joe.
And we are Two Crazy Ketos.
And if you're new to our channel, welcome. Here on Two Crazy Ketos, we do different things like recipe videos and we do product reviews. And we talk about various keto topics, and every Monday, we sit down on the couch for Keto on the Couch. We just kind of talk about what's going on in our lives for the week.
You can find us in different social media platforms like Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter.
And we have a website, which is twocrazyketos.com, and that's where you're going to find all of our different recipes. Now, we do upload at least 5 new videos every single week, so make sure you subscribe to our channel.
And don't forget to hit the little bell icon, and that way, every single time we upload a new video, you'll be alerted to it.
So, of course, we decided to do a video, and there's a helicopter now flying over us.
And there are some horses whinnying.
Is he gone?
I am not sure. He could do a flyback.
We got helicopters, and we got horses, and we got traffic, and we tried to escape the noise, and we found more noise.
I actually just saw, like, an animal services vehicle, so I'm kind of wondering, like, what animal are we picking up here?
Well, there is equestrian, like, camping here, so maybe they're checking on, like, permits for the horses and stuff, because it is, like, you know, a water management area, so you have to have the right vaccinations and
stuff. Hopefully it's not a crocodile.
So here's the thing. So I was on Facebook this morning.
Okay.
And, I was scrolling through, and I was in a specific group, and I'm not going to say what group it was, and somebody posed a question about a recipe because the recipe had a little bit of milk in it.
That's a four-letter word.
And it immediately brought out all the keto police that milk is not keto, no matter how little or how much you take. If you're having any milk, even in, like, as an ingredient in a recipe, you're no longer keto.
It's a no-no no matter what.
Yes. And I venture to say why. That's first of all. But here's the thing. This is just a subject that gets under my skin.
Why does it grind your gears?
Because there's no such thing as a keto food.
How do you figure, sports fan?
Because keto is a metabolic state.
Okay.
It's not a food.
All right.
And Let's talk about what is keto. Keto is where your body begins to burn fat, either the fat that you're consuming or the fat that, like, you have stored on your body, like all of these big man boobs that I have.
Aw, they're cute.
You're either burning dietary fat or you're burning body fat for fuel instead of carbohydrates. Now, you really want to get some keto police on us. You could technically get into ketosis while eating carbohydrates and sugar. And you've proven that.
That is true. I kept my calories so low that I was literally putting myself into, like, a starvation state that made my body have to go into fat reserves.
Yes. Now, if you do it too long, you end up with other problems with slowing down your metabolism. But there was a period where Rachel was eating a bunch of calories, and then she went into a 30-day fast where she was only consuming about 350 calories a day of Slim Fast and coconut water, which both of those have a lot of carbs and sugar in it.
I would not drink any, either of those things now.
Yet, when we tested your ketones 15 days in, your ketones were like over a 4, right?
It's true.
Which is how you started keto.
Yeah.
So if those products, we can all agree that drinking a Slim Fast shake is not keto. I'm not talking about the keto version. I'm talking about the original Slim Fast in a can.
Right.
We can all agree that that is not a keto product. How did you get into keto with it?
Because I had not enough calories.
Right. Because that's what ketosis is. It's your body's way of not starving itself. It's going to use the fat for fuel. So there's no such thing as a keto product. There are keto-friendly products.
So products that would support you being able to continue feeding yourself with a fat fuel source.
Yes, there you go. And see, some people react differently to products than other people. For example, we can all agree that stevia, for most of us, I think, can agree,
okay,
that stevia and erythritol and allulose are keto friendly.
Yeah.
Right? Can we all agree on that?
Yeah, they're not going
to... zero calorie.
Take you out of fat-producing
right.
food.
Zero calorie. They are low or zero glycemic on the index, which means they shouldn't be spiking any insulin or having any kind of, you know, insulin response. Yet some people, when they have those products, end up with elevated insulin levels. Not glucose levels, insulin levels.
Okay.
Why? Because everybody's body is different. So even if it's got those healthy, clean ingredients in it, it's still not a keto product.
So it could work for one person and not work for another.
Right. So back to the milk thing, there's nothing wrong with milk. Here's why milk in itself is not super keto friendly. It's high in sugar.
All right.
But milk is technically the same thing as heavy cream. Right? It's just heavy cream has less sugar, more fat.
I mean, it's where butter comes from.
Right. So you have milk, you have butter, you have clarified butter. And that's why you can be actually lactose intolerant and a lot of times still have butter and even sometimes have heavy cream because there's less or no lactose in it.
Do you think that what people are speaking from is a place of fear? That if we open the door to certain things like milk,
right,
that you're gonna overindulge, therefore I wanna shut it down for everybody.
I don't know. I don't know why people get this way. My point was is you have to look at the labels, you have to look at ingredients, and you have to know how your body reacts to things. Now, I'm not saying go out and drink a gallon of milk because that's not a good thing either because you're gonna be drinking way too much sugar. We're really not designed to drink milk once you're like weaned off of like your mother's breast milk and stuff. That's why so many of us, you know, end up with like reactions to drinking milk. But even yeah. Dr. Berry has talked about like if you have to drink milk, you want to drink whole milk. You don't want to drink skim milk or like the 2%, which is what I grew up drinking. Why? Less fat, more sugar.
So you always want to be just checking in with your own body.
Right.
And I mean, there's some things that I think we could agree on. I would just avoid, but not just for keto, but for any diet. Like,
right.
I don't think that sugar is good for anybody's plan.
Right.
Therefore, whether it is keto friendly or not keto friendly, it's nobody friendly.
Right. It's the same thing with the oils. So we all talk about like the bad oils, right? Canola oil, corn oil, all of these different processed oils. We all say that you shouldn't eat them.
Right.
Technically, here's fighting words again, all of those oils, they're keto friendly.
But they're not people friendly.
They're not people friendly. That's the difference.
They're not human being friendly. And the same thing goes with some of the Frankenfoods that we're seeing on the market. Because I think that if you put into a lane, this is definitely keto, then a company could manipulate you in the reverse way. So
right.
You're avoiding everything that has milk in it, but you're totally opening the door to anything that has egg in the title.
Right.
So if you have like a Just Egg,
right.
It's going to keto based on the nutritional level of it, but is it really going to forward your momentum and your health goals with all of the wonkiness in the ingredients?
You got it.
Yeah.
So what it comes down to is look at the nutrition labels on everything. Look at the ingredients. There's a lot of products out there now that they're putting keto on it. And when you pick it up, it's loaded with sugar. It's got a bunch of extra carbohydrates in it. It's got a bunch of wonky fibers and wonky ingredients. But they're slapping the label keto when people are buying it. And then on the other side, there are products where people are going to say, like, that's not keto. And having a tiny bit of, for example, sugar that was used to cure your bacon is not going to really harm you.
Right. So you don't want to avoid a recipe if you can keep it in check.
Look at the amount. Like
right.
If a recipe is calling for a tablespoon of milk and that recipe serves 6, that tablespoon of milk is not affecting you and therefore does not make this product not keto or this recipe not keto.
But here's the opposite way, you really have to know yourself.
Yes.
So let's say walnuts are in a recipe. Everybody's going to be like, yes, that's fine. That's keto. But for me personally, buying the bag of walnuts in order to have like a fourth of a cup of chopped walnuts in this recipe, I may be trying to like gravitate to recipes with walnuts because I want walnuts in the house.
Yeah.
And I'm going to over abuse walnuts.
Right.
Whereas if you had a recipe that called for milk, I'm just going to use it in a recipe. I'm not going to have a problem with milk, but I might have a problem with walnuts.
That's true.
So I think you have to know yourself
yeah.
and be willing to face your particular issues.
Yep. And here's the other thing everybody needs to have. Grace for people who can eat and tolerate things that we necessarily can't. Whether they're keto people or they're not keto people. There are plenty of times where I look and be like, I wish I could have that keto-friendly product, but that keto-friendly product messes with me. But I need to have grace for the people that can have that stuff.
I feel like this is this whole entire video, which this conversation was your idea.
Yep. Because I got annoyed.
But
I need to stay off of Facebook. That's what I need to do.
Right. That's number one. Stay off of Facebook. But I think it's also motivated as a cry for help because I get very angry with Joe that there are certain things that he doesn't have a problem with and his body doesn't react to like the way that my body reacts to it. So I want to eat what he's eating without seemingly any problems. But if I have like a tablespoon of it, like it's a problem. So yeah. I think it's just the same thing. Like if you have curly hair, you want straight hair. And if yep. you have straight hair, you want curly hair. And it's just like we get angry that other people can get away with things that we can't get away with. But yeah. I need to just stay in my lane.
Yeah. Well, that's going to be today's little rant video. Now, if you have ever had anything like this happen to you, either like in a Facebook group or somebody in like real life, and where they've told you like that's not a keto product, or maybe there's a product that you can't have that you know other people have, or products that you can have and you know other people can't have, let us know down in the comments section. Now, if you like seeing videos like this, we have an entire playlist of keto conversation topics, which we're going to link right down here. Also, make sure you take a look at our most recent video, which you can find right over there.
But whether you head this way or you head this way, don't forget to head this way. Subscribe to our channel and click the little bell icon, and that way, every single time we discuss something over coffee, you'll be alerted to it.
Until next time.
Bye.